Hi, in this video lecture, let's discuss about the construction of registers. What are registers? Registers are memory components that are directly accessible to the processor. The data required to be processed by the current instruction is held in the register. Since the processor has direct access to the registers, registers have to operate at the speed of the processor. The speed of the processor is determined by the clock pulse and so as the registers. Thus, registers have to be built by some memory components that is driven by the clock pulse. Such components are the flip-flops. Hence, a register is a group of flip-flops and each flip-flop share a common clock and is capable of storing one bit of information. So, for building a n-bit register, we need to have n flip-flops so that it can store n bit of binary information. This is a simple design of 4-bit register. We have 4 flip-flops, D flip-flops, A0, A1, A2 and A3. All the flip-flops are connected to data lines I0, I1, I2 and I3. And they are driven by the common clock, and there is an asynchronous reset button which will clear the content of the flip-flop. So whatever data that we wanted to load, we will have it in the data line, and when the clock pulse goes from 0 to 1, whatever data that is held in I0 to I3 will be loaded into the flip-flops, and that will appear at time t plus 1. What is the duration of this memory? Whatever data that we have in the data line will be loaded into the register when the clock goes from 0 to 1. Why? Because this is a positive edge triggered flip-flop. And suppose if we change the data during the next clock pulse, whatever information that we have stored in the register will be lost and the new information will be loaded. So the duration of the memory is just one clock cycle. This is not desirable because when we wanted to store some data, maybe that we wanted to retain the data for some time. So we can modify the design of this register to include a 2 to 1 mux to every flip-flop input. One of the input of the mux is connected to the previous data that is stored in the register, and the other input of the mux is connected to the data line. Any one of the input, either from the external input or it is the internal data that is stored in the circuit, is going to be fed to the flip-flop. There is a load line which will determine which of the lines is going to be transferred to the flip-flop, whether it is the old data or it is the data from the data line. So when load is 1, we are going to observe the data from the data line and pass it to the D flip-flop. If load is 0, then this line is connected to the AND gate. So load is 0 here, the complement of load will be 1 here. So this AND gate will be enabled, and whatever data that we have here will be passed on to the OR gate, and that will be coming to the D flip-flop. When load is 1, this line is going to be 0, but this line will be 1. And whatever data that is connected externally will be given to the OR gate, and that will be transferred to the flip-flop. So either I can retain the old information or the new information will be loaded. So this is the design of typical register.